Warm greetings, Lana. Myself, Dr. S. Chandralrani, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Velamal College of Engineering and Technology, Madurai, will be presenting a short lecture on the topic Applications of Operational Amplifier as Sample and Hold Circuit. The topic for our discussion will be in this flow: what is a sample and hold circuit, why MOSFET is used as a switching element in this circuit, and where the sample and hold circuit are used. As a definition, it states that the sample and hold circuit samples the applied input signal and holds the last sample value. And this storing of the sampled value, it will be held until the next signal it is sampled again. This is the circuit of an SNH. Here you can find that there are two operational amplifiers, namely A1 and A2, where A1 and A2, they act as a voltage following circuit. And between this A1 and A2, a storage element called capacitor C, it has been connected, and a switching element, an enhancement type MOSFET, has been connected. And there are two input voltages applied to the circuit. One, it will act as a control voltage, and the other, it will act as a input voltage. So this one, it is an externally applied input voltage, and it will be sampled by the control signal VC. So here the sampling of the voltage, it depends upon the application of the control signal. So the reason why the MOSFET has been selected for switching action, it is when compared to a bipolar junction transistor, the switching characteristics of a MOSFET, it is better. The reason it is a unipolar device. Always in a unipolar device, the conduction, it is dependent on the majority carriers. Whereas in a bipolar device, the conduction, it is contributed by the majority carriers as well as the minority charge carrier. So here, the minority charge carrier, they will pull down the switching characteristics of the BJT, and hence, we don't prefer BJT and we are selecting MOSFET for the switching action. So this is all about the construction of a sample and hold circuit. So next we will get into the application of the sample and hold circuit. So this sample and hold circuit, it is used in digital interfacing. It is also used in pulse code modulation system, and it is also employed in an analog to digital conversion system. So the reason why it is being used in the above mentioned applications are certain levels of the input signal are to be sampled and used for its application. So that's why under such condition, sample and hold circuits have been employed. We'll get into the operation of sample and hold circuit. So assume that the control input voltage, it is positive. This positive voltage, it will turn on this enhancement type MOSFET, and this, it will make the capacitor to charge to the instantaneous value of the applied input Vi with a time constant of RC. And here the input voltage, it appears across the capacitor, and then the output circuit, it will be getting its output as the A2's output voltage. So here A2, it acts as a voltage following element. So the next case, it can be what happens when the control voltage, it is zero. So when the control voltage, it is zero, this MOSFET, it will be turned off. So due to the off nature, the capacitor, it will hold its charge and it will not discharge its charge to the voltage follower circuit, that is A2. So already sampled charge, it will be presented at the output terminal. And this is how the circuit's waveform, it will be. The applied input, it is a sinusoidal signal. We have a control voltage of VC, which will sample for a time period of TS, and it will hold for a time period of TH. And this sampling and hold time, it will be reflected in the output signal, where you can find that this particular time period, it will perform the voltage following action in the circuit, and hence whatever you have in the input, that it is being transferred to the output. And during this time period, this particular input signal, it is not given here. The charge in the capacitor, it is being given as its output. So that's why the circuit, it is called as sample and hold circuit. To conclude, the sample and hold circuit samples the applied input signal depending upon the application of the control signal. As mentioned earlier, it is being used for analog to digital conversion circuit. It is also used in digital interfacing network and it is being employed in pulse code modulation system.